What's going on, world? I'm Kevin Hart, and I want to welcome you to Coldest Balls Season 10, live from Vegas. There he is.
There we go.
There he is. Come on, Kirk.
What's up, Kev Dog?
Put your robe on the hook back there, then we'll come and get in the tub.
Okay.
This is big. I appreciate you coming on, man.
I appreciate you having me. It's an honor.
What's going on, everybody? Hello.
Hello.
I am here with the legendary Kirk Cousins. Show some love. First of all, congrats on a phenomenal career thus far.
I appreciate that, man. We're coming off the torn Achilles. Got a nice little scar right there.
Yeah,
working through that. And next season will be year 13. I'll be 36 years old.
36 years old,
trying
man.
To play a few more years so my boys can remember me playing.
As a player that's been active for so long, to face an injury like this, how has it played on you or your mental?
It messed with me a little bit at first, but you know, it's part of the plan, and this is going to hopefully just be a little bump in the road as opposed to an actual, you know, something that wiped me out.
When you go through the world of injury, how do you occupy your mind? You're used to being active. You're used to being on the field.
A lot of Legos.
A lot of Legos.
A lot of Legos. I went to the lady at the store, and I'm like, all right, you need to get your mind right because we're about to just buy up this store of Legos. Yeah. I'm on a scooter with I'm like wheeling through the store, right? I got the lady, and I'm just pointing at the shelf like that one, that one, that one. Just throw them in the car.
Are you completing the sets, though?
Oh, absolutely. We finished what we start in the Cousins family.
What's the biggest build?
The Lord of the Rings Rivendell set.
Get the fuck out.
1,000 pieces.
That's a big set. I want to talk to you about the Netflix series because it allowed people to see you behind the scenes, how you embrace your family.
Sure.
Was that your reason for wanting to do the project?
Part of it. I wanted to chronicle the season so that, because my boys are young, that when they're 10, 12, 15 years old, we have something to go back to that they can see.
Yeah.
And even someday for my grandkids,
you
know, to have that content, I thought it'd be really cool. When you have cameras around, it's a little invasive, but we thought for the long haul, it would be well worth it. My wife's here today, Julie.
She is. Hello, Julie. She is. I see her.
I got two friends here, my brother Kyle, and then my high school friend Ross. They're in solidarity with me here in the robes.
Julie, I love you dressing Kurt. I love you
all the time.
Really embracing the space.
She picked this swimsuit.
You just don't want to deal with the world of clothes at all.
I can't.
It's just not your thing.
If I had picked it, I would have picked one that already you'd be like, strange choice.
I don't look at these as a strange choice.
Yeah, you like this suit because she picked it.
Okay, well, I want to embrace Julie and the job that she's done thus far.
Absolutely.
Julie, the world of like a dad and dressing like a dad, he's embraced at the highest level. I like it because it's like a great mixture. Yeah. There's this dominant personality on the football field, but off the football field, it's just like the cool dad in a very like a tame, look at this. I'm sorry. Daryl, they're paying homage
That's
to you.
Absolutely.
I like
look.
It.
He's got the
chains. I like
chains.
It, Daryl. You did a good job.
He got the chains.
Let me see. Yep.
There we go.
Bam. That's a little, those buttons are screaming for help, but outside of that, I have nothing bad to say. This is one of the first times I actually have nothing bad to say. The jewelry and everything.
That's pure class.
Okay. I don't want the chain. Bam. He doesn't want
there
the chain.
There we go. Here we go.
Okay.
Kurt, here we go.
You don't need the.
Oh, what's happening?
Can I do the interview, please, Bam?
I have questions I want to ask. Thank you.
It's Thank happening.
You. I appreciate you, Bam. Okay, thank you. All right, Daryl, get your ass back.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That looks like somebody I'd want managing my finances.
Well, no, that guy actually is not who you want managing your finances at all. Take it back. Take your chain back. There you go, Daryl. You pissed him off. Thank you. Bam, go. Bye. Question for you real quick. What is your biggest concern during a snap? Are you ever concerned with the smell of the center and you down there?
First thing I do post-practice is go to the bathroom sink.
Yeah.
Scrub my right hand.
Right hand.
Because, yes, it is a problem.
Smells.
And we have had some close calls with some centers who had some brown stains.
There you go.
On white practice pants during practice.
Yeah.
I tell them, go change your pants.
Yeah,
now.
You shit on yourself.
Yep.
And ultimately, that shit will be on the reverse side of my palm.
Yep.
Wash your man.
My immune system has to be so strong.
Yeah. White hand, please. Thank you.
There you go.
Let me tell you what alleviates my concerns. It's Old Spice Total Body Deodorant Spray. That's right. It gives me 24/7 freshness from my pits to my toes and everything down below with daily use. Yep, not a plug at all, Kurt.
Shameless plug.
Nope, not a plug. White hand, take that back. Thank you. The Washington Redskins and your career with the Redskins, RG3, he gets hurt. His injury provides an opportunity. It's an opportunity that you took and you never looked back. I do want to know what the mindset of a Kirk Cousins is during that time.
When I got drafted, Kyle Shanahan was our offensive coordinator. He called me after I got picked and he said, all right, so the plan is that you back up Robert, you'll play really well in preseason games, and in 2 to 3 years, we'll trade you. That's the best case scenario. Like, we basically drafted you to become a trade asset that we can get more picks for later.
Okay.
With the way things played out, I ended up playing well enough that I just stayed there. Really, the game that changed everything was we were 2-4. I was playing. I had thrown more interceptions than touchdowns. We get down 24-0. I have a bad sack and a fumble that they return for a touchdown. We're getting booed in our own stadium. I'm pulling turf out of my face mask. I had this thought of, like, maybe I'm just not meant for this. Like, maybe my ceiling is to be a backup. And we go out, we score on the next possession. We start scoring again. Next thing you know, we came back and won 31-30.
Wow.
And it was kind of this moment of excitement and energy. And I go through the tunnel coming back from the game up to the locker room. And I look at a camera like this one and I go, you like that?
Yeah.
And that happened. And that's kind of followed me ever since.
Kurt, let's get in the tub.
Okay,
it's real. It's about to get even more serious right now. Kurt, I want to talk to you now.
I love that for me.
We go from the Washington Redskins, and now we go to Minnesota.
We've been in Minnesota now 6 years. I was 6 in Washington, and now 6 in Minnesota.
You're in the conversation of elite quarterbacks. Who are your elite quarterbacks?
All time?
Let's go all time.
Right now, all time.
Can we do a breakdown of both? Okay, come on. Just put it in. Put it right there. Bam. Bam. Bam, hurry up. Just put it right there. Okay, thank you, Bam. Okay, all right, Bam. Put it in the goddamn thing.
It's so good for the tissue.
God damn it.
Nice and cold.
Sorry you had to hear me get like that.
It's okay. It's okay, man.
Okay.
It's okay.
Kurt.
You just gotta have grit, man. You gotta have grit.
Okay. With that being said, Kurt, the Mount Rushmore.
Tom Brady.
Nice.
And then it gets kind of murky from there. Peyton Manning, 5
okay.
MVPs.
Got two.
Tough to beat. Ah, man, I love Drew Brees.
I like that.
Joe Montana's probably got to be there. And that fourth spot, man, you can go anywhere from Bart Starr all the way to Mahomes today.
What are your picks for now?
Patrick's number one. I think it's kind of Patrick, and there's a little bit of a drop-off to everybody else. Man, I'm trying to think here. I'm going to leave somebody out. That's the biggest problem.
Come on, Kurt, stop about it and say it.
Brock Purdy. See, this is what I'm getting. I'm getting from the gallery. Jordan Love got hot late
this season.
You can't
let these people make decisions for you, Kurt.
Dak Prescott was a finalist for MVP.
Answer the f***ing question.
Josh Allen led the league in touchdowns. It's a great argument. I'm just going to keep punting until we move to the next topic.
So the only decision.
Legos
okay.
Or,
the only one that you'll say is that right now you feel like Patrick
it's
Mahomes.
It's Mahomes and then everybody else.
Okay.
Which disrespects everybody else. But
okay. Have you started thinking about, you know, what the world of life after football will be for you?
Certainly, being a stay-at-home dad sounds intriguing.
Yeah.
But outside of that, you know, I've enjoyed some of the business stuff I've been able to do off the field, so I think that I'll pursue that a little bit.
What is your guilty pleasure? You know, everybody that partakes in this world of entertainment.
I absolutely love donuts.
Donuts? Okay. I'm going to f*** you up. I am. I'm going to hit you. I'm going to punch you. Stop it. Don't you hear me doing the questions? All right. Okay. I'm
Here we
sorry.
Go again.
No. God. Thank you. Got it. I think my mic went out.
I told you that was enough.
Well, as a fan of the game and somebody that has watched it extremely close, the credibility attached to Kirk Cousins is extremely high.
I need you as my hype man before every game.
I would be your hype man if you let me get your alter ego. If I get, what is it, Kirko Chains?
Kirko Chains.
Yep. How did this happen? Is this from you on the plane?
Yeah, so we beat the Saints in London, and we had like a 10-hour flight back to Minnesota from London. And our left tackle, Christian Darrisaw, was a younger player, had just splurged and bought himself a custom chain with a spinner. So first class on the plane was like a nightclub. They had like boomboxes going, everybody was having a blast. And next thing I know, CD was sitting behind me, his chain comes over my head and drops on my shoulders, and everybody started taking photos and putting it on social media. And well, then we got on this win streak. So then the next away game, I mean, I'm like not even boarding a plane yet, and they're like, what do we got this time? You know, like, what's happening now? Next thing you know, I got guys Rolexes, and I got more chains. And then the next win, I guess I'll just take my shirt off. I don't know where this goes from here now. I looked at a teammate at one point, and I go, just how much money is on my person right now?
Yeah.
And he kind of looked, he's like, at least $1 million.
Of just jewelry and stuff.
You know, how do you top that? I was like, where do I go from shirt off and $1 million of jewelry? I don't really know. We haven't figured that out yet. But,
do you splurge at all? Is there anything that you do splurge on?
Not really.
Is your wife the splurger?
Somebody's really.
Got to spend the money, Kurt.
I said to her, like, what would you like to splurge on? And she said, I want a dog. And I'm like,
okay.
I don't really think that splurging
is really.
A dog.
Not really.
I was like, go get a dog. Yeah. And so that we got a dog like a week later. Now she wants a second dog. Now that I would call splurging. Well,
see, but now she's getting out of hand.
You give a mouse a cookie and they're going to ask for a glass of milk.
I've never heard that one.
Have you never read that book?
No, I've never heard give a mouse a cookie.
If you give a moose a muffin, never heard these books?
What the fuck are you reading?
You've read these books.
No.
You've read these books to your kids. I think you've deprived your family of some good nighttime literature.
Cheese. What happened to the cheese?
You got to Google it. That's all I can tell you. You got to Google
it. All right. Well, maybe I'm f***ing up as a father.
I don't think it's a maybe. I think it's you are.
I am. Okay. Yeah. I'm going to get the books. What I now want to talk about, I want to talk about the younger generation is playing the game. And I want to talk about you as a vet. Have you stepped up or acted as a informative source for any of the younger quarterbacks that are currently playing the game?
Well, I'll say right now, if there is a young quarterback who would like to talk to me, I absolutely would make myself available to say, hey, ask me anytime how I can help. I would love to help.
I love that, man. And I think the younger generation needs to hear more of that. What do they have to do? For what? For what, Daryl? Okay, you know what? I've had enough. I've had enough with you, and I've had enough with you. And we're going to have a meeting after this. And guess what? Somebody's not going to make it back after the meeting because you guys don't understand that I'm running a business here.
And business is booming.
You understand me, Bam? Don't do it. You're fired. You're fired. Curtin, I'm sorry you had to see it happen like
this.
Okay. I love to do this show because it's authentic conversation. To hear you talk and speak the way you do and just to hear your passion about life, it's inspiring and motivating. Yep. So I want to thank you, Kirk, for coming on Cold as Balls. Please show some love to Kirk Cousins one time. Kirk, that's it. Daryl, get his robe. God damn.
Can I talk down to him too?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
Yes, that's what makes the show special.